Himself was actually born in a zoo in Holland, and he came to us at only 1 year of age and weighing in at about 50 kilos. As of today, which we weighed him this morning, he weighs a record 220 kilos, and he actually still has quite a bit of growing to do. Now, did you know you've got something in common with Cisco? Have a look at your hand. Now have a look at his front flipper. The bone structure in your hand and his flipper are actually the same. Now those bloopers may look awkward for getting around on land, but they're surprisingly quite fast and quite nimble. So let's have a look as he goes. You can see as he uses all four of those bloopers, making easy work of the clip. Good job there, Cisco. Now those bloopers are obviously very well designed when it comes to use in the water. In the water. Now what he's doing here is called porpoising or bowing. It's a very quick and energy efficient way to get around our oceans. You might even notice he takes a quick breath of air while maintaining that speed. Now this is also used very well when chasing prey or getting away from predators. Now the ocean is a pretty big place. There are different types of predators out there, seals being one of them. There is, however, a different type. Now, this particular predator can actually be quite misunderstood, but it's still very important to its ocean environment. And Cisco's going to give you a bit of a clue as to what it is.
No, my sunglasses.
That was a little too small of a clue there, Cisco. Let's go right round. That's it. Any ideas? Shark. Yeah. Cisco does a great shark impersonation, but what you're seeing is a natural behaviour that seals use to cool down. Those thick fur coats are very good at keeping the heat in, but it's only those naked and hairless flippers that let the heat out. Now those front flippers are also very strong. A seal like Cisco can easily outrun us over short distances. So it goes to show that they actually have a lot of strength in that upper body. Isn't that right, Cisco? Well, that was our part of the show. We're going to use those flippers for one more thing. Oh, wait, you're fine. We're making way for a friend of ours. Please welcome our keeper, Annie.
Thank you, keeper Jose Diego. They do a great start to the presentation. So the next seal that's coming out is also a powerful Californian sea lion, and like Cisco, was also born in a zoo in Europe. But Pepper is a 13-year-old male. He has a very sweet personality, presently weighing 40 kilos heavier than Cisco. He weighs over 250 kilos. Now, we weigh ourselves every Friday morning. Now, between Pepper and Cisco, though, they are both breeding boys and fighting for dominance. So we have to wait for one to go home before we bring the next one out. But Pepper is ready to come out and say hello. Let's say hi to the gorgeous Pepper. Good boy. Now, Pepper is here to show us all the life of a sim. Life for a seal out in the wild isn't always easy, and human impact is one of their greatest challenges. Pepper, you did a great job to get you a big bucket of fish. Did he do a great job, everyone?
Yeah.
Have you noticed how well our seals catch the fish when we throw it to them? That's because of their amazing whiskers that help with the sense of touch. Now, Pepper, let's give everybody a closer look. For this behaviour, I need everybody's help. Looking at Pepper's face, and on the count of three, everybody calling out the word whiskers. One, two, three.
Whiskers!
Good job. It's those amazing whiskers that help seals find fish in dark and murky water, hunt for food at night, and also at great depths. Those whiskers really are very sensitive. Now, Pepper at the moment is eating 13 kilos of fish every single day. That's two full buckets full to the brim. But Pepper, what happens when that fish runs out? It's very sad. We're overfishing our waters, making it harder and harder for Pepper's wild cousins to find their next meal. Now, Pepper, do you want to come on down by the edge of the pool and see if you've left any fish behind? But just a quick look, okay? Did you see anything? No. Now, Pepper, is there something that we can do to help your wild cousins? Yes, there is. Your choices matter. The next time you're out there purchasing seafood, look for products with the MSC blue and white fish tick that you see on the wharf below Pepper. The MSC fish tick, the Marine Stewardship Council, means that by purchasing products with that tick, you're supporting a fishery that supports fish stocks, jobs, and their environment. And buying products with which tick? Means that you're helping secure a healthier future for all the marine animals that really do need our help. Pepper, which one are we looking for? That one there, that's right. And that makes Pepper a very happy seal. Pepper, where's your happy face? There it is. Good job as always. Well, we're going now, we're going to make way for the next of our seal friends. We're saying hello to Jose with his seal Bobby.
Well, it's not Jose, it's Jacob, hi. Well, hi everyone, my name is Jake and this here is Bondi. Bondi looks completely different to the other species of seal that you've met today, and that's because Bondi here is a New Zealand fur seal. Now, the name New Zealand fur seal is a little bit misleading because this species of seal is native to our shorelines as well, found right across the east coast of New South Wales, and that's exactly where Bondi was found. Bondi here came into us as a rescued animal. He was found on Bondi Beach when he was only around 18 months of age. Now, the reason that he came to our wildlife hospital here is because he was bitten by a shark on Bondi Beach, and due to that, he spent a very long time recovering here at our wildlife hospital, around 4 months. Now, due to that, he was deemed unfit for re-release because he lost his skills in hunting. But that's not to worry, Bondi has quite a good life here at the zoo, and just last year, he became a dad as well. So now Bondi has a daughter of his own, which he's very proud of, I think. Now, part of caring for our seals means teaching them behaviours. And believe me, our seals would not do anything they don't want to do. All these behaviours take a lot of time and a lot of trust to train. Now, the behaviours in which we teach our seals can be anywhere as important, like helping care for them. This could be things like asking Bondi here to open up his mouth so we can check out his big teeth and his mouth. Looking quite good in there, buddy. All the other behaviours can be a little bit more difficult and complicated. And that's exactly what Bondi here is going to demonstrate. Oh yeah, not right there though. Come on, you Bondi. I need everyone's help for this one. What I need everyone to do is say jump Bondi on the count of three. And what Bondi is going to do, he's going to jump into the water and he's going to touch his nose on that orange buoy at the middle of stage. But for this, he's going to need a run up. So let's get him to the very top of the cliff. Watch out, seagull. Bondi will eat you. Alright, on the count of three, jump Bondi as loud as you can. One. Two, three!
Jump, Bondi!
He's looking very blankly. I thought you guys did a great job though, but if you have a look, Bondi's only got little ears, so we're gonna have to ask him. Hey Bondi, was that loud enough for you? He said no. That's totally fine. I think we need some more energy, and I reckon we can do that. On the count of three, let's say it one more time, and sometimes it... Oh, okay. Big round of applause for Bondi. Such a good job, Bondi. You guys did a great job as well. Bondi jumped the gun, but that's totally fine. Now, we really do appreciate everyone coming here today. We want you all to stay right where you are, though, because Bondi and another one of our seals will be coming back out to say our final farewell. Remember though, next time you're out shopping for seafood, choose MSC. Which one is it, Bondi? That one right there. And you too can be a champion for the wild. Bye for now.
This is advertising.